All right, table two on the left. On the right-hand side, we got Jason and Rob. And the lag.
Can you swivel that screen towards me a little more, Josh?
Big sticks versus FAQs. Big sticks is home.
Is it the same? Do I need to add that to the profiles?
Just you need to start a match with those two names. Yes, you do. Yeah, the answer, short answer is yes. You can answer either one, FAQs or big sticks, and add them both. There's 80, so just put plug. I think they drop them in alphabetically, though, so you can find them.
That's the 8 ball nationals.
Right now.
Big sticks.
And the OA team, what's your name?
FAQs.
Hey, Rusty.
What's that?
Heard you life at a party, man.
Oh, I'm not a life of any party. What are you talking about? Okay. This is Rusty Willard here. Grab a microphone. Say hello.
Hello, everybody.
It's nice to be here, man.
It's
really great meeting you and all the TAP crew.
I appreciate it. It's nice and, to meet you as well.
Thank you. I'm having a great time. And are you here to keep score on something?
I'm here to see this man right here.
Oh, gosh. Okay. All right.
He's the man of the hour.
That's right. He is the man of the hour.
New TAP app.
All right. Well, you guys enjoy this live stream. Every once in a while, somebody might pick up a microphone and say something silly. So it's usually me, but in this case, I'm going to be busy doing something. So in this case, it might be Rusty or Josh or Ian Brock. So enjoy this match, folks. 9 ball on the right, 8 ball on the left.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's chat about the app. Hey guys, how's it going? This is Joshua Junkata again with Runout Apps. I'm here with Rusty, as Dan was saying. Rusty is actually one of our premier testers that's been helping us out with the app, dealing with all the bugs and stuff that we had during testing. We've really appreciated his help. And actually, he's here to get hooked up with the app, so he's going to be most likely one of the first, or the first, director to get signed out and do all digital scorekeeping. So Rusty, how much time do you think the app saves or will save you once you get everything set up with us?
Once everything's set up, I think it'll save us several hours a week in data entry. You'll be able to just pull things up, do a quick review of it electronically, and submit.
And so right now, do y'all have to go and pick up all your score sheets, or are y'all doing the email thing?
Everything is picked up manually, yeah.
All right, so I assume that's a lot of gas money and time. And
well, luckily for me, I've got some very good players that are lifelong friends that do a lot of help, and they play several nights a week. So like the guy that plays Monday night, the last guy there, I carry it to Tuesday night. They save me quite a bit of gas. I got to give them a lot of credit for that.
That sounds good. So we'll be saving them some time then, too.
Absolutely.
So I expect a thank you card.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Just kidding. All right.
Stand by. We just need Josh to format the app in the window so that we can get it looking correctly. And then I'll have Josh back on the microphone with Rusty.
All set?
Yep.
All good?
Yep.
A little man's watching.
Yeah, you can say hi.
Go outside there. Go out there?
Yeah.
Oh, he's watching on the TV. I don't want to. Everybody's gonna look over here.
Nobody's gonna say anything. Oh, it's just on the stream.
Oh, just on the stream? Hi, Bobo.
Okay, let's see if these graphics are readable.
That's kind of funny.
Is there any way? Is there any way you can increase your resolution?
No. Oh, there you go. There you go. The problem is I'm doing it out to here too, so that decreases my resolution. So it is higher.
This thing is so cool.
Oh,
I can shrink the window.
No.
hard.
Yeah. Greetings, table 31, Scott Hayes and Borges Revenge. That's Scott Hayes and Borges Revenge.
That was the people that's coming to ask me for some reason.
Fine Gravity. The few players that are on my team are dragging that team onto the title. Because that was the old team.
Thank you.
Table 19, Chris and not Chris, and Lester Luck. Chris and not Chris, Lester Luck. Table 19.
Thank you.
I'll try to get the chat up here.
Shot. Thank you.
And we all four team captains from table 28 and 32 to come to the tournament desk, please. Stop your match and come to the tournament desk from table 28 and 32. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. The events that you're streaming in, when are they going to be available online?
3 weeks on YouTube.
Anytime or?
3 weeks. 3 weeks on YouTube.
Weekly?
3 weeks.
Oh, three weeks
on YouTube.
Okay, thank you.
How'd it go?
It went okay. Oh, you want? You want a drink?
You sure you didn't buy the dress on
that's a red.
Okay.
I'm not getting hungry, actually.
I am too. I need to eat. I don't need a drink.
You don't want
a drink? I'm waiting for Josh to get back for lunch. Yeah, and then I'm going to go get some food.
All right. Hey, everyone. Daniel back with you. And I'm going to let Ian concentrate on his scorekeeping duties here. He is the man responsible for all those jelly bean colored buttons on the screen. He's responsible in so many ways. He didn't design it, but he's the man responsible for the numbers changing on the board. Let's just put it that way. And this is great. We got live scoring using a digital scoreboard. The person who is streaming is there now. Yes. What can I do for you, Brander07, in the chat room? What I'd like to know is who is playing in this nine ball match? Can I have that booklet? Do we even know the teams? So selfish. Thank you. The Little Rascals and Kick Rocks, huh? Well, that would require me to get up. All right, I'll see what I can do. Get a line on who these teams are that are playing nine ball. I just don't want to disturb these players while they're in the middle of playing. If you see some goofy bald guy walk over there and ask those people questions, it's just me. Conway team from Pennsylvania. Ray Brooks shooting right now. Is playing the Balls Deep team from Washington, and I believe that's Mike Quigley in the red shirt. I have been wrong before, but I think that's Mike Quigley in the red shirt and the green cap. And as soon as this game is over, I'll get a score for you guys. Ray Brooks is playing as a five, and Mr. Quigley is now a four. So this would be a 5-4 match. You see that goofy bald guy over there? Okay. I'm talking about the table on the right-hand side. Mad Hatter. I'm not talking about the eight ball match that's going on between Crow and Frank. I'm talking about Raymond Brooks and Mr. Quigley here from Balls Deep, who is shooting right now. Mike Quigley. Well, no, actually, Raymond Brooks is in the black shirt right here with the Kamui logo. He's shooting right now against Mike Quigley. He's playing nine ball. And like I said, I will get a game score on this match on the right-hand side as soon. If you look at the scoreboard on the left-hand side, those are your names and those are your scores there. It is now 2-2, correct? In a race to 5-4. And Mike with a good opportunity to run out here. Six ball down the rail, she goes. Seven ball. Cut it too thick. And he's going to leave Ray a little bit tough here. Ray may even opt to bank this seven ball back in the opposite corner. Oh, he plays a soft shot. He played a side-to-side safety. Not a bad shot, actually. And forcing Mike to bank at the seven, misses and leaves Raymond open. You're obsessed. Here. All right, settle down, Ray. Not too hard. Uh-oh. Therein lies the problem. Looks like he might be calling the side pocket here. Tell you what, if it was me shooting, that's probably the pocket I would have to call. Looks like it might go to the corner, too. I mean, it's just, you know, when you're that close to your work, it's a shot like that to the corner is pretty tough. He's straighter to the side than he is to the corner, that's for sure. Oh. Well, look at this. He leaves Mike pretty close to his work now. You got a good roll off that side pocket, that's off the titty there. Mike takes his marker. Raymond replaces it. And that is end of match, actually. So I'm gonna find out how many matches. Hey, Ray. Hey, Ray. Raymond. How many sets ahead are you guys, or what's the set count? It's 1-1. Okay. What was that? A race to 4 or 5? So it was a 5-4 match. Okay. Nice win, bro. Raymond Brooks, everybody, playing with the Conway team, and we're going to find out who they're playing next. And we'll start another match between the two teams right after this. Please enjoy the eight ball shenanigans happening right next door. Crow takes down another game. Game count now, I believe, is 3-2. Crow goes to 5. And our scorekeeper is zeroed out. And ready for the next game. Well, I've seen a lot of 2 second ball breaks here at this event with the eight ball, but I don't think I've seen a lot of front ball breaks here, and Crow's got a pretty powerful one. By the way, I just want to mention to you guys that the team nine ball top first prize is $5,000. And the team eight ball first place prize is $10,000. All right.
Hey, guys. Can you get your names?
Dan Reed. Dan Reed is playing as a 4. He's the one racking right now. Playing against Jeremy Hartle. And he plays as a 4. So this is an even 4-4 race. Good luck to both players. May the best man win. Jeremy breaks and scratches. Thank you. Sorry about the confusion there with the scoreboard, the new scoreboard down there. Jeremy versus Dan Reed is accurate.
Thank you. Thank you. want to do it.
Chat room, I have an update for you regarding the Kick Rocks and the Little Rascals teams. Just remember, I work for tips. But anyway, the Little Rascals are out, I'm afraid to say. They got knocked out. And the Kick Rocks team were very upset and rude to me because they are getting annihilated, and they just kind of felt like I was asking them to rub it in. But they said that they're getting kicked to the curb, actually, so they're not doing well either. I'm really sorry to break it to you that way, but Kick Rocks are not doing well. The Little Rascals are out. So any other questions? How's my boy Dan Reed doing over here? Shooting on the 5-ball. By Dan, good speed, just missing the 9-ball and pocketing the 7 in the bottom right corner. Damn, I bet that hurts.
641-142-577-659-577-659.
And Jeremy marks the 9-ball to the corner pocket.
599-098-599.
And there we have it.
640-1.
of beers that we're doing first ever live streaming. Make a press release. First time we do this.
I'll get right on it, sir.
He's got the press release and everything else. We need to push out the press stuff too.
What's the score, Jeremy? To you? 2-1, Jeremy Hartle against Dan Reed.
Have you sent me anything? Send me something.
578875.
Yeah. Send me something.
640055.
Send me the press release.
640055. 641297.
Double hill here.
641297.
The press release is on.
639137.
Dan Reed takes a game. It's now 2-2. Oh, sorry about that, Dan. It's now 2-2.
Five seven seven one three seven.
Possible bank shot on this too, but he looks to be looking at a safety of some kind, or safety is a good shot. No.
577.
Didn't quite get there.
578861.
James plays a bank, doesn't go. Banks it short.
598-799.
A lot of numbers being called. None of them are mine.
640111.
That was a very nice, both those shots, the two and the shot before that, where he used the two to make the seven.
640650.
Except he's hooked on the four ball right now.
641893.
Plays a good safety. 599. We got a grindhouse match going on between Crow and Frank Raymond here, 4-3. The intensity in both of these players right now is pretty dramatic. Side timeout on the eight ball side. We got two timeouts happening consecutively. Thank you. Huge round of applause there. And Frank wins the match against Crow. Quite an elated team receiving mountains of support from his teammates. Crow, slightly disappointed.
Crow was 47-10 overall with 11 defense. And he left Frank 5 left on the table. Frank was 44-15 with 4 dead balls, 7 defense, 10 left on table, and 3 made on a break. It was quite a hill match, Daniel.
Woo! And we will continue this madness. The hijinks. The drama. I was just about to go order a burger. Oh, the room? Sure. So I'm assuming we have another match coming up on this table, another eight ball match. I'm just waiting for them to decide which team players they're going to put on. Dan plays a very nice shot on the eight. Slow rolls his cue ball into the nine, and he ends up straight. And that makes the score 3-2. Dan Reed in the lead against Jeremy Hartle. And how's Josh doing?
Just ate a burger.
Huh?
Just ate a burger.
So just ate a burger.
Now I'm actually though feeling a little sleepy.
Now you won't. Now you need a nap.
Now I need
you need either a nap or a hot fudge sundae, right?
Either.
Woo.
That sounds good.
Yeah, exactly. Actually, I could use a blizzard. A blizzard from Dairy Queen. Right about now.
Large.
A large blizzard.
I need the blizzard.
Steve Hellfish in the chat room asking how high do these ratings go up for the players? Well, for the Nationals, the ratings go as high as 7. But I do believe that they can go as high, up to as high as a 12 or 13, if I'm not mistaken. But I'm still becoming, something like that. I'm still becoming familiar with this league, so you have to bear with me. But I happen to know that it's a very simple system. It's just that there's so many. You know, when you become acquainted with a new league, there are so many facets to that league that are tough to get your head wrapped around sometimes. But I heard up to 13. I could be wrong. If anybody in the tap who is in the chat room would like to provide some insight. Or you can also check out thetapleague.com.
All right, we got Christopher King versus Blair. And right now, Blair is being occupied there by the open player spot because his handicap for the tournament is actually lower than what we have in the database. So his actual handicap is a 5, so we got a 4-3 race.
So Josh, you got your keeping score over there between Chris King
and Blair.
And what?
Blair, and I couldn't catch his last name. I had to actually drop in the open player because his handicap was...
I'll find out his name, though.
Yeah. Open player slot there, it's actually Blair Morris. Sorry about that. I actually had to drop in the open player so I could override the handicap, but that is Blair Morris.
Versus James Hartle.
Or no.
That's fine. Timeout, Chris King.
Nah, it's fine.
Good shot, but bad leave on the 8.
All right, buddy. Good to go.
Appreciate it, man.
Any problems? We got 2 days to get it right.
I'm gonna leave tonight. It's the right one you put on there, right?
Yeah.
That's fine.
Put it on a laptop, maybe. Give it a check.
All right, thank you.
Appreciate it. Hey, thanks again.
All right, thank you.
I gotta get some food, man. Yeah,
I know. I felt good to get some food in the house. And a defense. And Chris misses the 8.
Yeah.
Sorry guys, I was talking to a tap official. It looks like Blair won that match. So that's one for the away team. Blair Morris with the win. Just started the second match. Nothing dropped on the break. Player calls a safety before the shot. Leaves Chris in a pretty tight spot. Thank you. So everyone who's listening in on the stream, TAP Corporate just officially announced that Scorekeeper 2.0 is in the store and ready for download. I know some of you guys snuck in and got it before the official announcement, but it is now officially available. So please go download it and support Runout Apps. Spent a long time working on that. Have your directors contact us on Facebook, Twitter, however you get them to us, and we will set you guys up for a complete digital scorekeeping. Nice cut there by Chris King. Looks like Chris King has a chance to get back in this. The only problem is that one ball is sitting right up next to the eight. Chris King. 10 seconds, and he's good to go.
Is it under? What's it under?
Scorekeeper 2.
2.0.
Yeah, 2.0.
That's all I need. Scorekeeper 2.0, not run out of apps or nothing like that.
Those probably won't work for a few days until Apple indexes it.
Right now, Scorekeeper 2.0.
Right now, but if you're looking on it. Blair Morris with a chance to finish it up here for this game. Not an easy shot on that 8. Yeah, strange angle. He did make it. Let's see if Chris can finish it up. Chris King on the 8 with a chance to finish it up. Oh, couldn't do it. And also, it gets left with an easy finish there for Blair Morris. And Blair gets his second game. Here's your current totals. wrist drops, one on break. Chris King is actually down 2-0, and I'll do a quick explanation of the scoreboard. On the very upper part of the dashboard, the first thing you see is the timeout clock. The second item there that says home is the number of home games that the home player has completed or won. That's the overall total for the home. Then you have the games, there is the number of games the current home player has won. Then on the right-hand upper side, starting from the far right, is the shot timer, which will toggle to 45 seconds. And then next to it is the away overall total for the away team, followed by the away games won by the current away player.
Thank you.
timeout for Chris King. Eight ball's in a really tough position here for Blair Morris. Timeout, Blair Morris. Thank you. Chris has a chance here to get one in the bank. Oh, man, he can't do it. Gets a decent leave, though. It's not the easiest shot for Blair. Chris gets one. Thank you.
going to start up selling the singles, but first we want to have a nine ball.
Thank you. Yeah, 3. Yeah, the yard. So this guy's Chris, right?
Yes, Chris.
Yeah.
You know what, I'm just gonna get some right here.
Oh, that's good.
Don't move.
Hey, what's your number, by the way?
Oh, yeah. It's a...
Larry Fisher, Randy Bradwell, 52. Larry
your singles directors are to the right of the head table, to the left of the TV. If you want correct answers for any of your singles questions, go down to see the singles directors and their staff down there, please.
First of all, if you're not able to set up your mic between you for your time of sports meeting, you are the reporter is in between that. First of all.
Your opponent is not here.
7 handicap. Aaron Todd Carter. Shane Morrow, table 36. Aaron Todd Carter. Shane Morrow, table 36. Tom Savage and Tony Bird, table 41. Tom Savage and Tony Bird, table 41.
Yeah, no, I've got them for 3 or 4 times. Yeah, we actually just did. We have several. I think he's got all the similar numbers. I just don't have them. I'm not like, I'm done remembering it for 6 times.
You'll have to just get it.
I don't, it's okay.
I think how you hit the ball, John, I'd almost never tell nobody to do that. because there's a chance of missing you and shit like that, and I'm fucking that's the way you play.
New York, Tony, stand to 141. Your opponent is on his way. Tony, stand to 141. You don't have to defend this one.
So Chris King had 29-16, 13 dead. Wow.
John Wall, table 60. John Wall, table 60 is your first call.
Gotcha.
Here, how you doing?